students, good morning. How are you? I hope you all are good and studying properly at home. Children, we have completed chapter 18 and IQ test 1 in our previous videos. I have given some important questions also for your exams. I hope you are studying all those things and you have completed. So, today I am here with the new chapter, that is chapter 19. In your book, chapter 19, Fairy Tales and Comics. It is on page number 25. This chapter is very much interesting because it has many stories. In this chapter, we'll identify the main characters. You can see here, four pictures are there. These four pictures are actually four stories. And we have to identify the main characters of these stories. So let's have fun with this chapter. We'll study and find out the main characters and complete our chapter. Now I am going to show you the book closely and I will tell the stories one by one. And afterwards we will fill the book. Okay? So please take out your GK book, a pencil and an eraser. And open page number 25. Okay? Children, you can see this is your chapter 19, Fairy Tales and Comics. Please open page number 25. Today we will study this chapter. This chapter is based on some stories. 1, 2, 3 and 4 pictures are given in this chapter. We have to identify what picture is this. This picture is related with which story. Okay. So, now I am going to tell you the story with the question. I will read the question. Then I will tell the related story. And you will get the correct answer. Okay, so let's start our chapter. The first one is, who ate the three bears' breakfast of porridge? Who ate the three bears' breakfast of porridge? Three bears' ka breakfast kisne khaya? So this question is from the story Goldilocks. Are you ready for the story? Who was Goldilocks? Once upon a time there was a little girl. Her name was Goldilocks. She had golden hair. One day, Goldilocks was walking in the forest. She saw a house and knocked on the door. She went inside. Okay, she saw a house and knocked on the door. Then she went inside. फिर वो अंदर चली गई. Nobody was there. Goldilocks saw three bowls on the table. Three bowls. B-O-W-L, bowl. Okay. She was hungry. Wo hungry thi. This porridge is too hot. In that bowl, there was porridge. P-O-R-R-I-D-G-E. In that bowl, there was porridge. And this porridge was not for her.
This house was not for her. This was the bear's house. You can see in the picture. Three bears are there. This story is the Goldilocks and the three bears. Correct? So she is the Goldilocks. You can see in the picture. She is a girl and three bears are there. And the size of the bears are different. Very big, big and small. So three bowls were there and these bowls belongs to these bears. Okay. So she saw the bowls and there was porridge in the bowl. She checked all the bowls. The first one, about the first one, she said, this is too hot. And for the next, that belongs to the next bear. This is too cold. Okay. And then next, when she checked, she said, this porridge is just right. Goldilocks ate all the porridge. Okay. She ate all the porridge. Goldilocks was tired now. Did you get the answer? Who ate the three bears' breakfast of porridge? The answer is Goldilocks. This girl, Goldilocks, ate the three bears' breakfast of porridge. Goldilocks. Okay, Goldilocks. She ate the three bears' breakfast of porridge. Okay, let's complete the story. It is interesting, na? So I have to complete this story. We have the answer, but for you, I have to complete it. So Goldilocks was tired now. She was very tired. So she checked the chair first. This chair is too big. There were three chairs. Huh? She said, this chair is too big. Next one, this chair is too big too. For the next chair, she said, this chair is too big too. Next chair, she checked. This chair is just right, but the chair broke. Goldilocks was very tired. She went upstairs. This bed is too hard. She went upstairs and then she checked the bed. This bed is too hard. This bed is too soft. And this bed is just right. The small bear's bed was just right for Goldilocks. Okay? Soon the bears came home. Someone's been eating my porridge. The big bear said, someone's been eating my porridge and it's all gone, said baby bear. Someone's been sitting on my chair and it's broken, said baby bear. Someone's been sleeping in my bed and she is still here. She was tired and still she was there on the bed, said baby bear. Goldilocks woke up and saw the three bears. Help! She ran downstairs and into the forest. She never came back again. Okay, children. So this was the story of Goldilocks and the three bears. Next question. Who does the glass slipper remind you of? Who does the glass slipper remind you of? Glass slipper आपको किसकी याद दिलाती है? This story is the story of Cinderella. Okay? Who was Cinderella? Do you know? You must know. Because you all love stories, comics and cartoons, I think. Correct? Okay? Let's start our second story about Cinderella. Once upon a time, in a village, there lived a beautiful girl. In a village, a beautiful girl was there and her name was Cinderella. And she was living with her wicked stepmother and two stepsisters. She worked hard all day. One day, they all went to a ball in the palace, leaving Cinderella. Okay? Leaving Cinderella behind, they all went to a ball in the palace. Cinderella was feeling sad. Suddenly, there was a burst of light and the fairy godmother appeared. With a flick of the magic, she turned Cinderella into a beautiful princess with glass slippers and a horse at the door. The fairy godmother warned Cinderella to return before midnight. Cinderella arrived at the ball. The prince saw her and fell in love with her because she was very beautiful and she was the prettiest girl in that ball. Okay? They danced together all night. As the clock struck 12, Cinderella rushed out to her carriage, leaving one of her slippers behind. That glass slipper she forgot. The prince went to every house in the town with the slipper until he found Cinderella. The prince and Cinderella lived happily ever after. Okay, this was the story of Cinderella. So this answer is Cinderella. 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 Okay? Next question. Who did the seven dwarfs find sleeping in their bedroom? This is your third question. Who did the seven dwarfs find in sleeping in their bedroom? Seven dwarfs ne apne bedroom mein kisko sota hua paya? So let's find the answer in our story. Okay? Once upon a time, a king and a queen lived in a very big and beautiful kingdom. They had a gorgeous daughter. She was very beautiful with black hair and fair skin and her name was Snow White. What was her name? Her name was Snow White. With the years, the princess grew up, becoming more and more beautiful and kind. But sadly, one day her mother died and went to heaven. After a while, the king had married to the new queen. After some time, that king married with the new queen. But she was not good. And she did not like Snow White. She had a magic mirror shoe. So she asked the mirror, who is the most beautiful queen on the earth? So the mirror replied, it is Snow White. Her name is Snow White, who is the most beautiful woman on the earth. After hearing this, she got very much angry. So she ordered one of her soldiers to kill the Snow White. The soldier took the Snow White in the forest, but he did not kill her. He could not kill her because she was a nice person. She was so beautiful and kind-hearted. She was so beautiful and kind-hearted. That's why he could not kill her. She ran and ran with all her strength in the forest. Now she was very much tired. Then far away she saw a tiny house and decided to get inside. When she came in, she saw that everything is quite small. In that house, everything is quite small because it was the house of 7 dwarfs. So that's why everything was quite small, and as she was tired, so she laid down on the little bed and fell asleep. Okay? After some time, 7 dwarfs came into their house. When they saw Snow White, they got surprised and said, "What is this beautiful girl doing here?" After some time, she became friends with the 7 dwarfs. She cooked food and danced with them. One day again, that queen, asked to the mirror, "Who is the most beautiful woman on the earth?" And the mirror replied, "It is Snow White." She got angry again. After knowing this, where is Snow White is living, she decided to kill her. So she planned. She turned herself into an old lady to be able to go to dwarf's house without being noticed. She knocked the door, and when Snow White opened the door, she saw an old lady. But this old lady was the queen. She said, "Beautiful child, take this delicious apple. I am sure that you have not tried anything like this before." She took the apple that Snow White took the apple and bit it. Without knowing, the evil queen has poisoned the apple. She fell on the floor after taking the bite and never woke up. So the little dwarfs got very sad and decided to place her on the flower bed in the forest. One day in the forest, a handsome prince came and he saw the beautiful Snow White on the flower bed. And he fell in love with her and kissed her hand. At that moment, she woke up because the kiss broke the queen's magic. She was pleased to see the handsome prince. She also fell in love with him. The prince and Snow White lived happily ever after. Okay? So the answer is Snow White. The fourth question is, whose nose grew in length when he told a lie? In this picture you can see a boy and an old man. So who is the one whose nose grew in length when he told a lie? Let's start our story. A long time ago, there were a person called Geppetto, G-E-P-P-E-T-T-O, Geppetto. He was old and lived by himself. He was a carpenter. He is Geppetto. He was a carpenter. He loved to create stuffs from wood. One day he thought to make a puppet out of wood. He said, "I will make a little boy and will call him Pinocchio." He said to himself, "I wish Pinocchio were a real boy." A fairy heard his wish, so she decided to grant his wish and make the wooden puppet come to life. She said to Pinocchio, "You must promise to be a good and honest boy." The next day, Geppetto was very happy to hear Pinocchio talk. He loved his wooden son very, very much. He smiled and said, "Now you can go to school with all the other little boys." Okay? At school, Pinocchio saw that he was different from other children. And he did not like this. He did not like school and he did not like doing any of the thing like homework or anything else. So he started telling lie. Every time he lied and his nose grew longer. So the answer is Pinocchio. When he started telling a lie, his nose grew longer. P-I-N-O-C-C-H-I-O. Pinocchio. So let's complete our story. One day Pinocchio decided to hide from his teacher. He hid inside a big toy box. But he could not get back out. Okay. वो एक बिग टॉय बॉक्स के अंदर छुप जाता है अपने टीचर से. बट अपने आप को बाहर नहीं निकाल पाता. सो ही शाउटेड. चिल्लाता है. Somebody please help me. The fairy appeared. "Why are you hiding, Pinocchio?" Pinocchio started to lie. वो झूठ बोलना स्टार्ट कर देता है. His wooden nose grew longer and longer. His nose grew as long as a tree branch. The fairy decided to help Pinocchio one last time. She set him free. Pinocchio came out the toy box. His teacher asked, "Why were you hiding in the toy box, Pinocchio?" Then he told the truth. "I don't like being different." The teacher smiled and said, "We are all differing from each other. That is what makes the world an interesting place to live." Okay. Pinocchio went home to Geppetto. Pinocchio told Geppetto about his new friends at school. The fairy saw how Pinocchio had changed. She decided to turn him into a real boy. Pinocchio and Geppetto lived happily ever after. So children, we all are different. And Pinocchio understood this thing. He understood that I am different. This is not a bad thing. This is a good thing. And this only makes the world an interesting place to live. Okay? So, we have completed this chapter. I hope you liked this chapter. I hope you love this chapter, right? Please learn all the answers in this chapter and spellings also. We'll meet in the new video with the new chapter. And I hope that will be more interesting. Okay, thank you. Bye.